Hey everyone, and welcome to Top Think. Today, we're going to find out if you are good looking or average. Now let's begin. Beauty is in the eye of the beholder. Everyone has their own tastes and preferences. Some people swoon over blue eyes and blonde hair. Others fall head over heels for tall, dark, and handsome. Even though our preferences differ, some traits are generally more attractive than others. If you surveyed the entire population, you could create the ideal human form. In fact, many studies have. A 2016 study from the journal Evolutionary Psychology discovered the ideal body types for two groups, men and women. A 2011 review from the Royal Society of London collected the most attractive facial features from hundreds of scientific studies. Several more studies have used computer generation to create the perfect man and the perfect woman. This person, by society standards, is the ideal representation of beauty. Collecting traits from all ages, races, and backgrounds, they represent the average preferences of our culture. So how closely do you resemble the ideal person? If our society rated your attractiveness, where would you fall? This test can tell you exactly how attractive you are. Now, before we get started, let's keep one important thing in mind. Attractiveness can be standardized, but beauty is personal and diverse. Some people are attractive to most of the population, but others appeal to a smaller crowd. This test is not designed to criticize your appearance. The most striking people often differ from society standards. Just because you don't do well on this test, hey, that doesn't mean you aren't attractive in your own way. Alright, with that said, let's dive into our attractiveness test. This test will consist of 5 sections. Each section will analyze a different aspect of attractiveness, including physical features, personality traits, and social history. So why do we need to look at so many different areas? You may think attractiveness is purely physical, but it's not. Attractiveness is a multifaceted concept. The same traits can be interpreted in dozens of different ways. To properly measure your attractiveness, we have to look at more than just your physical appearance. That's why this test analyzes your looks from 5 different angles. In each section, you'll have a chance to answer a few questions. Be as honest as you can. If you don't respond honestly, then your score won't be accurate. The goal of this test isn't to score as high as possible. The goal is to get an accurate understanding of your own attractiveness. As we go through each section, keep track of your points. You may want to write them down. At the end, we'll total up your points to find your final attractiveness score. Now that score will tell you whether you're good-looking or average. Ready to get started? Number 1. Physical confidence. Are you a confident person? Confidence is one of the most attractive traits in both men and women. But what does it mean to be a confident person? A confident person has the courage to be themselves. They own their own successes and failures. They stay true to who they are because they like who they are. So ask yourself, am I happy with myself as an individual? If the answer is yes, then give yourself 2 points. There's one more important aspect of confidence. You may be confident as a person, but are you confident in the way you look? Do you, for example, like to look at yourself in the mirror? The vast majority of people say no. They think they need to lose a little weight. They wish they could change their appearance. But if you like the way you look, other people will too. Do you feel satisfied with your appearance? If you do, give yourself 2 more points. Number 2. Social allure. Do you have a strong external appeal? Do other people find you attractive? There are small and subtle ways to tell if other people find you appealing. If, for example, do people laugh at your jokes? Studies show that people laugh more often when they're around someone they find desirable. The same goes for eye contact. People unconsciously stare at attractive people. Do you catch people displaying positive body language around you? If you do, give yourself 1 point. Compliments are another easy way to measure your social allure. Do people often compliment your looks? You're likely more attractive than you realize. If you've received compliments on your appearance, go ahead and give yourself another point. You can also analyze your personal history to gauge your external appeal. Have other people had crushes on you? Did you find them attractive? People are typically drawn to those at or above their own level of attractiveness. If good-looking people have liked you, you're probably good-looking yourself. So give yourself another point. Number 3. Aesthetic characteristics. In this section, we have to talk about men and women separately, as our sources make this distinction. Desirable male characteristics are very different from desirable female characteristics. For example, strong, square jawlines are an attractive feature for the ideal male. For the ideal female, men and women both prefer a softer, rounder face. So, let's start with men. What aesthetic characteristics do men and women find most attractive? The most attractive masculine traits are, in no particular order, a muscular chest, a strong jawline, a full head of hair, broad shoulders, and an attractive smile. If you're a man, give yourself 1 point for each masculine trait that you have. Now, let's look at female aesthetic characteristics. In general, men and women prefer women with more feminine features. The most attractive traits are large eyes, an athletic torso, curvier hips, long hair, and like men, an attractive smile. So if you're a woman, give yourself 1 point for every trait that you have. Number 4. Attractive passion. Sometimes the most attractive thing about someone isn't their body, it's their passion. Potential partners want someone who's ambitious, disciplined, and focused. Someone who's chasing their dreams with everything they have. Your passion breeds a unique confidence and charisma that people find irresistible. Are you passionate about your career? If you are, give yourself 2 points. Career passion isn't the only kind of passion out there, though. You can also be passionate about a hobby, a sport, or a subject. Many people hide their interests and passions. They worry others will judge them for liking something obscure. Whether you carve statues out of bronze or build dollhouses for fun, any passion can be attractive, as long as you own it. Let your passions define and motivate you. If you're proud of your passions, go ahead and give yourself 2 points. If those passions happen to be creative, such as music, writing, or painting, give yourself 1 more point. People are especially attracted to creative minds. Number 5. Total proportionality. Finally, let's talk about physical proportions. Men and women come in all shapes and sizes, tall and short, thick and thin, but what body types are the most attractive? The ideal male proportions are different from the ideal female proportions. In men, the trapezoid is the most attractive body shape. Trapezoid bodies have broad shoulders, a larger chest, and slimmer hips. Men with trapezoid bodies are typically muscular, which adds to their physical appeal. Though trapezoids are the most popular, triangle and rectangle-shaped bodies are desirable too. If you're a triangle or a rectangle, give yourself a point. If you're a trapezoid, take 2. Studies also show that men and women prefer males who are taller. The average man in the United States stands around 5 feet 9 inches. If you're 5'10 or taller, give yourself another point. In women, society prefers a more athletic shape, but that doesn't mean rippling muscles and broad features. In fact, the ideal female has much more body fat than the ideal male. She has a curvier shape called an hourglass figure. An hourglass figure emphasizes a woman's chest and hips with a slimmer waist. If you're shaped like an hourglass, give yourself 2 points. Men and women also show a preference for longer legs and a shorter torso. If you have long legs, give yourself 1 more point. Alright, that's the end of our test. So let's find out how you did. On this test, your attractiveness score can range from 0 to 20. The closer you get to 20, the more attractive you are. On average, people score between 8 and 12 on this test. If you score within that range, your attractiveness is about average. You have a number of socially attractive traits, but not all of them fit the ideal image of beauty. But average isn't always a bad thing. According to a 2013 study in the Journal of Psychological Science, normal-looking people are the most sought-after partners. Most people are average, so they're looking for someone similar. If you scored higher than 12, you're more attractive than the average person. You have many physical and psychological traits that people are drawn to. If you scored a 16 or higher, you're an extremely attractive person. To the average stranger, your appearance is desirable, your proportions are flattering, and your confidence is irresistible. So, did you get the score you thought you would? You may have scored lower or higher than you predicted, but hey, that's okay. This test contains only a handful of traits that people find attractive. The truth is, individual beauty is impossible to measure. An experience, for example, can change someone's perception of you. You may find someone attractive because of a moment or memory that you shared together. So if you didn't get the score you wanted, don't worry. Don't criticize your appearance or lose hope. Our social standard is one definition of beauty, but there are many others. Hey, thank you for watching Top Think, and be sure to subscribe because more incredible content is on the way.